IntelliJ IDEA, with the Scala plugin, makes your coding experience more enjoyable with features like Inlay hints. These subtle annotations display helpful information like insert types, parameter names, and more next to your code. It's like having augmented code that's easier to read without having to bloat your project with extra text. But here's the thing, while these hints can improve readability, if you're an experienced developer familiar with your code, they can also have the effect of making your editor feel cluttered. This makes you want to go to the settings and turn them off. But then, quite often, you might look at a piece of code and feel like it would be useful to be able to see that extra information once again. You then have to stop, dig into the settings, and re-enable them. Then you finish working with that unfamiliar piece of code and you turn Inlay hints off again. All this switching means you break your flow. That's where our X-ray mode comes in. It solves this constant tug of war by letting you toggle hints on demand without disrupting your focus. Let me show you how these two features work together. First, let's open the settings window and go to Editor, Inlay Hints. Here we have a list of possible inlay hints and a checkbox for each element on the list, which lets you decide if you want that particular type of inlay hint to be displayed. Let's start with parameter names. If you write a call to a method whose parameters include some basic types that are likely to be passed as literals, so for example if you pass a parameter called enabled as either true or false, then IntelliJ IDEA will display the parameter name as an inlay hint to the left of the value. However, the scope of this feature might change, so in the future you may be able to see parameter names for more complex parameters too. Next, we have types. This is a fairly self-explanatory setting. In Scala, we don't have to explicitly write the types of values, variables, or class fields, or the return types of methods. We typically do so anyway for public class fields and methods, but for private and local elements, not so much. This inlay hint simply lets you see their inferred types. You may use it as a more straightforward alternative to the type info pop-up. Then we come to values, which in the case of Scala is effectively a very specific inlay hint category that helps you when you're working with ranges. We have two types of ranges, exclusive and inclusive, exclusive being the default one. This inlay hint is helpful if you have trouble distinguishing one from the other. Finally, there are inlay hints for method chains. In Scala, we often chain calls, especially when working with collections or monads. We take some original data and call a method to transform it. The method returns an instance of a different type, and we call another method on that one, and so on. For every method call in the chain, we know its result type, but they are not explicitly in the code. So it becomes difficult to understand what is happening when the chain gets long. If you turn on inlay hints for method chains, you will see the result type for each intermediate method displayed on the right side of the given line. Moreover, this useful feature motivates you to put each method call on a separate line, which is a good coding practice. Beyond this, we can also check out the code vision category of inlay hints, which includes usages and code outer. Usages displays the number of, well, usages of a given method in your project, which may help you decide if it needs refactoring, while code outer is basically git annotate as an inlay hint. Now that we've covered those, we can move on to implicit hints. We won't find these in the inlay hint settings. They are enabled with an action, which means we can look for them, for example, in the keymap settings. Here they are. If I add a shortcut, let's say Shift Ctrl Option equals, and then go to the editor and use the shortcut, an implicit hint will be displayed next to the sorted method there. The sorted method has an implicit parameter known as ordering. That ordering is defined here above with a given and then passed to sorted. Since it's implicit, you won't see any reference to it in the call, but sometimes it's useful to know it all the same. But what's not useful is having to define a shortcut for each inlay hint or, as I mentioned before, switching back and forth between settings and the editor. For this, it's more convenient to use X-ray mode. Let's switch to a real-life project. Here you can see a part of the IntelliJ Scala plugin, the class called ScalaDocContentGenerator, and the method visitParagraph. We use ScalaDocContentGenerator to render ScalaDoc comments behind the scenes. So now, if I go to the top of the method, create a ScalaDoc comment block, and click Toggle Rendered View, ScalaDocContentGenerator starts rendering its own documentation. Now, if I press and hold Command, or the Control key on Windows and Linux, X-ray mode is enabled, and that means that some of the inlay hints we have just discussed will appear in the editor. All you need to do is press the Command or Control key. It's much easier than having to memorize all the complicated individual shortcuts for the different types of hints. The inlay hints you can see now are for method chains and local value types, and here is one for implicit conversion. Similar to how implicit parameters work, the Scala compiler must first augment the value here with one more call to a constructor of an implicit class. With inlay hints, you can see it as if it was expressed explicitly in the code. However, X-ray mode is not limited to inlay hints alone. Look here, those vertical lines are indent guides. If you want to enable them permanently, you won't find them under Editor Inlay Hints, you will need to go to Appearance instead. In fact, the list of possible hints that X-ray mode displays is defined in a separate view, which can be found under Settings, Languages and Frameworks, Scala, X-ray mode. Here, you'll find all the hints we've discussed, plus indent guides and method separators, which are thin horizontal lines between methods, also lambda types and variable patterns, which are hints about types in pattern matching, like this one. You can also choose if you want to enable X-ray mode by pressing and holding the command key, or by pressing it twice and holding it down. There's also a second way to enable X-ray mode, because why should we limit ourselves to just one, right? In the top right-hand corner, you can see the eye icon. When I click on it, IntelliJ IDEA will display the available inlay hints, just as if I pressed and held the Command or Control key. The icon even changes to indicate that I've enabled it. If I click it again, X-ray mode is disabled. Under the icon, there's also a quick route to the X-ray mode settings. So, it's effectively like we have three different ways to use inlay hints. First, we can permanently enable or disable them, and we can configure them via editor inlay hints. Second, we can use the temporary X-ray mode, where hints are visible only for as long as we are pressing and holding the command key. Finally, we can toggle the X-ray mode on and off by clicking on the eye icon. However, if you think you don't need this toggleable approach, you can go to the X-ray mode settings and make the icon disappear. And that's all. Thanks for watching. To learn more about what IntelliJ IDEA can do for you, look for more videos on our channel, like and subscribe, read our blog, or chat with the development team on our Discord server. Links to all of these resources can be found in the description. Happy developing!